This video, we're going to be doing an unboxing, an overview, and an install of the EVGA GeForce RTX 3050 XT Black Gaming Graphics Card. I know, it's incredibly rough to find one, and then if you can find one, finding one for a good price. It actually took me a long time to find this one. But anyway, let's get to the unboxing. As soon as we're done with the unboxing, I'm gonna show you how to install it. All right, so here we can see again the EVGA GeForce RTX 3050 XT Black Gaming Graphics Card. EVGA did send this to me to review. So along the side here, nothing much, just EVGA XT GeForce RTX 3050. Along the back here, we can see the features, the specs, and all that good stuff on the card. Don't worry too much about that. Same thing along the side. The bottom, black, and the top, serial number, UPC, all that good stuff. Let's go ahead and open it up real quick. All right, now the reason I do these unboxings, you can see here, nothing inside of the box, is so that you know what comes inside the box and aren't caught off of guard. Okay. Nothing in here. And it looks like it's just the card all wrapped up. No adapters or anything along those lines. All right, so we can see this is a dual fan card and it is PCIe 4.0, though it is backwards compatible. Just make sure to remove this before attempting to install the card. And it also has this plastic cover over it. Just make sure to remove it. All gone. You can see the fans have that little EVGA logo on it. And it does have these little curves and the lip in black, as you've come to expect now. You can see the large heatsink and the copper pipe on the inside. This does require an 8-pin PCIe connection. It also requires a minimum of 550 watts, though you can go as high as you'd like. PX1 back here. Then we can see there is an opening on the back of the card to allow when the fans blow through the card. It actually literally blows through the card, helping to dissipate all the heat through the rear. And we can see UPC serial number, all that good stuff back here as well. This does have 1, 2, 3 display ports and one HDMI 2.1. Removing that as well. They do a lot to protect the card, just to make sure it doesn't get scratched or anything. Along the bottom of the card, more of the heat sink, then the connections for the fans. This does have 2,560 CUDA cores, 1,777 megahertz boost clock. Then along with the 8 gigs of RAM, this does also have a 14,000 megahertz effective memory clock speed, as well as 224 gigabytes per second memory bandwidth. Now the card has a total power draw of 130 watts. Now the card measures 8 inches from the rear of the card to this, the front of the card. I'll go ahead and put the exact measurements on the bottom of the screen. Almost 2 inches in depth. And then measuring like this, 98.33 millimeters, that's about almost 4 inches. With all that said, let's go ahead and install it real quick. We're going to be doing some preparation on your system before we install the video card. Whether you're coming from on-die Intel or AMD CPU graphics, or you're coming from a full-fledged AMD or Nvidia card, I highly recommend you do this because no matter how good or how bad performing the card is, you want the card to perform as well as possible. You just spent money on this. You don't want to blow that money, right? Anyway, let's get started. So you can see we are running an Nvidia card. No matter what we're running, we'll open up Edge or Chrome. This is a brand new install of Windows. We're going to go to wagnardsoft.com and we're going to go to scroll down a little bit and we'll go to DDU, the latest version. Scroll down a little bit more, click here for download and support. and a little tiny bit more official download here. That's going to go ahead and install DDU. So while that's downloading, we'll go to nvidia.com, we'll go to drivers, select GeForce from the dropdown, 30 series, select RTX 3050. Whether you have Windows 10, 64-bit, 11, 7, select your version. I'm using 11. And then we'll click search. Here we'll find the latest version. It could be newer by the time you get to it. And then click download here. And again, download here. Okay, so now we'll go to open file on DDU or wherever we've downloaded it to. Double click on that DDU file and then on the C drive, we'll create a directory called DDU and extract it there. That automatically created that drive. And just to verify, here we see it right here. So now we're going to go into save mode. We'll hold the left shift key. Then we'll right click on the start button, hover over shutdown or sign out, and then we'll click restart. So now here we'll go ahead and select troubleshoot, advanced options, startup settings, restart the change Windows options, such as we're going to want enable safe mode and click restart. All right, so then here we're going to go ahead and select enable safe mode. Mind you, you can enable safe mode with networking or enable safe mode with command prompt, but we'll go ahead and do number 4. Here in safe mode, we'll just go to the root of that DDU folder. And we'll run display driver uninstaller. So then we click OK over here. You have to be incredibly careful here. If you're running an AMD chipset motherboard, so you have an AMD CPU in your system, you're going to want to go ahead and remove all of this because it could mess with your chipset driver. Mind you, you can always reinstall it, but it's a little bit easier if you uncheck this. Now we're removing NVIDIA drivers because we had a 3060 in the system before. So we'll check everything here, and I need to minimize this a little tiny bit. And then one very important thing, if we scroll down, prevent downloads of drivers from Windows Update when Windows search for a driver for a device. We want the place to check in that. Click OK here, click close. Now over here, we're going to go ahead and select device type. We're going to be removing the drivers for a GPU, and then we'll select NVIDIA, AMD or Intel, whichever we had before, we're going to select here. So now, because I had an older NVIDIA card, I'm removing the NVIDIA driver. It doesn't matter that I'm running a 3060. It could be whatever NVIDIA card. This is just an example. And then we'll go ahead over here and click clean and shut down. Clean and shut down because after it's done cleaning the drivers, we want the system to shut down so that we can install the new video card. Again, this just makes it so that your drivers get uninstalled completely from a third party, WagnerSoft DDU. It completely removes everything NVIDIA has there, or AMD or Intel, giving you the perfect base to install your brand new drivers so that your system only sees your brand new drivers, nothing more, nothing less. DDU only takes a few seconds to run. Any second now, we'll see it shut down Windows. All right, now let's get to install the video card. Now, depending on the video card we have in our system, if it does have a PCIe power connection, we're going to want to go ahead and remove that. So we'll just press on the little clip down here, holding the PCIe cable in place, and then we'll just go ahead, pull it out. We'll lay it down for right now since we will need it later on. Now we'll go ahead and remove the screws over here. This particular case, it's a Phillips head screw. You can't just pull the video card out because you'll end up damaging the motherboard. You'll notice right over here, there's a little locking mechanism that keeps the card in place. So we'll just go ahead, put our hand on the card. So what we'll do is with our fingertip or with any device, very gently push this down and that'll go ahead and unlock the video card. Now the video card just unlocked. And now we can just release the video card. That locking mechanism works two ways. The same way we pushed it down to release the video card, when we push in a new video card, this will go ahead and automatically lock in place. So I just unlocked it again. So now we'll grab the brand new video card and we'll slide these PCIe fingers into the PCIe slot. And then just realize that these two little metal prongs, they're going to go between the case and the motherboard, right behind the motherboard. We'll slide it in here. Now I can let go for a second. You'll notice that little locking mechanism. Again, when we push it in, it's gonna lock in place. And so we just slid in the PCIe fingers into the PCIe slot, and then the little locking mechanism locked and held the card in place. It locks itself on the little section on the card right here. Looks like a little arm. It just slides right in there and locks the card in place. Now we'll go ahead and screw the video card in place, same way we did before, just backwards. And then we'll go ahead and connect the 8-pin PCIe into the 8-pin PCIe slot right over here. And then this little locking mechanism that we pushed down before will automatically raise itself and then lock in place. Okay. And just clicked in place now. So we've installed a video card. Now let's go ahead and install the drivers. Now, just realize one thing. Depending where you were coming from before, you might be used to plugging in your video right up here. But now that you have a video card, you're gonna be plugging in your monitor into your video card, be it HDMI or any of the display ports or both. Now our system is back together. We'll go ahead and turn the system on for the first time with the new card. Now we have the card running on the new system. And of course, we have to install the video drivers. Now, if you're used to allowing Windows to do its own thing, which I never recommend, but remember what we did here is we stopped Windows from automatically downloading what they call the latest video driver. It's all on us now. If you remember, just before we booted into safe mode to remove the drivers, we downloaded the latest driver. So we'll go ahead and double click on that. Yes, over here. Then we'll go ahead and click OK. Then we'll click Agree and Continue. You can select whichever you want of these. I'm going to select the graphics drivers and the GeForce Experience. Agree and Continue. We'll choose Custom next, and then perform a clean install. Even though we've done DDU, I always select this because you never know what could happen, and click Next. This would only take a minute or two. Close that. And we can leave this checked or unchecked, however you'd like, and click close. Even though NVIDIA hasn't said to, for good measures, we'll go ahead and just restart the computer. It only takes a few seconds. When we're back in Windows, we're going to want to go ahead and right click on the desktop, select Show More Options, and click NVIDIA Control Panel. Agree and continue. Now, this is incredibly important so that you can get, again, all the performance from your card. Depending on your monitor, of course, we're going to want to go ahead and click change resolution. And because I'm running through a capture card, I'm stuck at 60 hertz. But first off, select the resolution you'd like. If you want 1080p, select it here. Or if you want 2K, or if you want 4K, just select it here. Make sure you select the highest refresh rate your monitor allows. Again, I'm running through a capture card, the Avermedia 2 Plus Live Gamer Portable. It only goes up to 60 hertz, but if your monitor does 120, 240, 144, 360, 500, however many hertz you have, select it, and you'll get that much better performance out of your card. This is a last minute addition. After selecting your highest possible refresh rate that works, of course, if you have G-Sync or FreeSync on your monitor, make sure to come here, click Setup G-Sync. Make sure you click to enable G-Sync, G-Sync compatible, enable for full screen mode, and then make sure that enable settings for the selected display model is selected. That way you can get so much more performance even above selecting the refresh rate. I hope this video has helped you not only with the unboxing so that you know everything that comes in the box and you can buy anything additional that you may need, but then also it helped you on the installation so you know exactly how to remove your old video card, how to pop in the new video card, and how to correctly uninstall and install all the latest and greatest drivers and remove your old drivers as well. So I will be doing a lot more on this video card. I'll be doing some gameplay performance testing as well as some fan testing. And then also I'll be doing some reviewing of it, comparing to other cards as well. I won't name those cards, but they're on the screen. But anyway, stay tuned here to This Bytes For You for a whole lot more on this video card and lots more. Iggy with This Bytes For You up. See you guys.